In my last video, I compared the filter sound of the Korg 770 to the Volca bass. Not 10 minutes after filming that video, this happened. The oscillator pitches are all over the place. Sometimes the pitch CV for lower notes actually disappears. Intermittent problems such as this are notoriously difficult and time-consuming to resolve. This project will prove to be no exception to that. Time to look up schematics and get started. Power supply. I always start my diagnosis by making sure the power supply is happy and healthy. Power supply problems can cause current drops and all sorts of crazy things to happen. Measuring the output, I get a minus 10 volts and a positive 20 volts. No deviations, no spikes, no ripples. Seems like it's okay. Since outputs are nominal, the Zener diode is probably okay. Huge solder globs on wiring can oxidize, becoming a major source for intermittent connections. I drained all of the solder with a Hakko 808 gun and re-soldered the wiring. One of the secondary wires was frayed and broke, so I re-soldered that. I pulled all of the power supply capacitors and tested them. They were high quality parts that tested very well with an ESR meter, so I went ahead and put them back in. I pulled the rectifier diodes and they tested great. I put them back. Power transistors provide the higher currents at the required voltage. They tested fine, but I replaced them anyway with new equivalents. For the 2SC1226A, I used a KSC1173. For the 2SA699, I used a KSA473. While testing, a secondary fuse opened. Well, they are almost 40 years old now and do not last forever. I replaced both of those and I added fuse holders to them. For now, I can probably eliminate the power supply as a suspect for my problems. Keyboard work. The problem could be an intermittent connection on the keyboard resistor array. I removed and flipped the keyboard. I reflowed all of the resistor and wiring solder points and tested them for continuity. Still no improvement in the situation. I probably have a pitch CV problem coming from one of the VCO boards. VCO 1 board. More huge blobs of solder. I removed the blobs, then resoldered the wires back. The coarse tuning selector was working, so the problem has to be upstream of that. I inspected the board and saw a burn mark near a capacitor, which I tested and replaced anyway. No improvements though. I pulled and tested other capacitors. They were fine. I replaced a few of those anyway as well. Tracing some signals, I found the pitch CV goes weird after the op amp. I replaced the op amp, but still had a problem. By the way, when you see a JFET pair, these are matched FETs. Matching FETs are not to be trifled with. I would ignore any of these matched JFETs I see. So anyway, it's possible that a bad component downstream could be drawing current away from the pitch circuit. I pulled and tested many transistors and JFETs along the way. Everything looked good. The VCO1 op amp is a sample hold that will hang on to the last pitch CV played, even if the key is let off. It does this by taking a trigger from a different board at the gate of a JFET. VCO1 also passes the pitch CV signal to VCO2 via the mode select switch, which was working fine as well. Since these signals are shared with a different board, I will start to look at the VCO2 board and see what I can come up with. VCO2 trigger detect board. Even more huge blobs of solder to resolve. Then I tested the connections to the VCO1 board for continuity. I investigated the VCO2 circuit for problems. Pulled transistors, JFETs, diodes, capacitors. Everything was good. I went ahead and replaced the VCO2 op amp anyway. I investigated the trigger circuit for problems. Pulling and checking transistors, capacitors, diodes, anything that might be going out. All was good there as well. Portamento, bender, vibrato. It is clear these signals all feed into the VCO1 pitch CV circuit as well. Any problems in these circuits could disrupt pitch CV. Also know that dirty switches and pots can introduce resistance and open connections to your circuit. I cleaned the switches and pots with care. There are small parts that can easily be damaged or lost. Still, no improvements. The switches all have small PCBs with wiring connections, so I reflowed those. And guess what? There were some improvements. The lower pitches did not disappear anymore, but they were still way off. So what in the world could be going on here? I must find a way to isolate the circuit with the problems. On the oscillator 1 board, there are two wires in point 112. I removed the wire passing pitch CV to oscillator 2. I had to leave the other wire as it is needed for fine pitch control. Like magic, oscillator 1 pitch was returned to normal. This means that the problems are on the oscillator 2 board. I put the wire back and checked the wire continuity to VCO2 again. It was good. Then I flipped the oscillator 2 board and reflowed some component connections going to the wiring areas. And presto, all of the pitches returned to normal. This 770 was back in action. The final problem had been an intermittent solder connection on the VCO2 board. Oxidized and frayed wiring with intermittent solder blobs were also resolved. Dirty pots and switches and their oxidizing connections were also taken care of. Thanks for watching.